Hey, what's up, guys? Got another little painting video today. Got a Ruger American 6.5 Creedmoor bolt gun. Just a cheap bolt gun I kind of put together for this little project. I'm gonna decide to paint it today. And I've got a Dickinson 12 gauge pump I bought just last week from Royal King, super cheap. Kind of just making like a budget shotgun, home defense build, you know, kind of a beater. And we're gonna paint it today. So, gonna get these bad boys tore down, prepped, masked up, and got my paint supplies over here, and got my table all set up, and let's get to spraying. Alright guys, so I've got this bolt gun kind of taken apart as far as like what I'm going to prep and paint. I plan on just doing a base coat to the barrel and the receiver, and then for the stock is what is going to get the camouflage pattern. So another thing to note, what I'm about to like mask up on here, the bolts that hold the receiver to the stock, I don't know if you guys do this, but what I typically do is just run those bolts back down in the threads, and typically I'll run them down as far as I can. And you're not trying to tighten them or anything, you just put them down in there where they kind of bottom out and just leave them. It helps protect the threads from any paint or anything else that could get in there and gum it up and cause problems later. So it's best if you just run the bolts down in there, and you can see where there's thread showing. If you guys want, I'm going to take tape and I'm just going to mask that off with the rest of the bottom half of this receiver and the trigger mechanism, the stuff that you won't see when it's in the stock, but you definitely don't want a bunch of paint up in it. It will cause problems later. But let's get this thing masked up. We're all masked up, ready to go, prepped up. Got the Rust-Oleum camouflage. This is the camo sand, so just a flat tan. I got these flipped upside down. We're gonna hit the bottoms first, let it kind of dry cure, and we're gonna flip it around and do the rest. Really just want to kind of apply something light, let it tack up so you don't end up running paint on it. So first coat, honestly, that's a little bit heavy. I should have went, you know, a little lighter, dusted it on more, but that's good. Ain't gonna make a big deal. Alright, so we got a decent first coat on. We're going to let that tack up real good and dry before we apply the second coat. Apply the second coat, flip it over, get the tops real good, and after that base coat dries, then we'll start adding layers of the camouflage patterns. Alright, we've given this about 30 minutes to dry, really. It's probably a little longer than usual, but I took a lunch break, so let's get this second coat on. I can already see light spots right behind the trigger guard, up inside the trigger guard. So we're gonna hit that with another good coat, and I'm gonna flip it and probably hold it while I kind of touch up some other stuff and get the top good. And for the barrel and stuff, that'll just get one more coat and that'll be done. That's just getting a base coat tan. The receiver's getting all the camo stuff. So let's hit this again. And yes, the bolt is painted. I know I'm a terrible person. That part of the bolt is painted, not a huge deal. I plan on putting a nicer bolt and stuff in it anyways, but I'll pull it out, probably just get some paint stripper, take it off, not a big deal. Boomers right now are freaking out. A little bit of paint on the bolt, in my opinion, is not as bad as having a bunch of paint gunked up in the trigger mechanism, you know. But whatever, we'll see. I may have really screwed up, man. Who knows? I'm just a dumbass already. Okay, got a little bit of an idea here. Stand it. I know the very front of that will probably get a tad bit messed up, but that is okay. Not a huge deal. Alright, so stock is looking pretty good. I moved the barrel and stuff. It's pretty much done. It's drying. So I'm going to lay this down and I'm going to dust over it with some more Rust-Oleum Flat Black. I'm going to dust over it in a couple spots, and then I've got my netting I'm going to lay over top of it, and we're going to start layering it and giving it that pattern. You'll probably say that I've done too many coats if I'm just going to shoot black on it. I could have just threw the netting on it and sprayed the tan, you know, and just done a couple coats with the netting on it here and there, but it's whatever. I just like a good base coat. Go ahead and stand it up and kind of do the other side. I really like doing the fan because you don't have super hard lines. It gradually fades. It goes from tan, fades into black, black fades into tan. I think that gradual fade in it gives it more of a, you don't really have any hard lines you can actually see. All right, now that we got it striped, we're gonna go ahead and take the netting, lay over it, get it situated, and start hitting it with some tan.
I know it's a little heavy right here on right on the grip, a little bit heavy at the top, but it's all right. We're just gonna lay this over, sprinkle some tan on it, pull the netting off, and we'll see where we're at. Like I said, it's just spray paint. If you hate it, you can try it again, try it again, try it again, try it again, until you get it right. Now, another tip. So I got this netting. You want to go to like a Hobby Lobby store that sells it like by the measurements, because you can get this stuff pretty cheap. So you get you a piece cut, like I think this is like a 3x4 or something, 3 foot by 4 foot, something like that. Just get it cut big enough where you can drape it over your rifle or whatever you're painting. There we go. Kind of get it pushed up in there against it so you can get some lines. You know, it doesn't really matter, man. We're not trying to win a beauty pageant with it. We're just trying to camo it. So it's fine if it comes out a little bit of a spray can, man. Come on, it'll be fine. All right, you got it covered. Let's go at it with some tan and see what happens. So whenever you're doing this, you know, you've got your pattern over top of it. You're not spraying the whole thing. You're just hitting the black spots, because now you're trying to do the contrast between the tan and the black, and also put pattern inside of the black. Let's start dusting it on there. And it's going to look, as you're spraying it, it's going to look real cloudy. But trust me, whenever you rip this off, it's going to look good. If you're questioning it, you're probably doing it right. Because whenever you take it off, you're going to be like, okay, it don't look too bad. Plenty of times I've done this where I'm like, man, that don't look that good. Maybe we need to try a different way. But I don't care, I'll take spray cans to pretty much in the end. Just a little spritz. Spritz. I mean, if you want to, you don't have to stop there. You could come in with other colors. I'm just kind of sticking to a black and tan for this one. So, yeah, you can change it up. Put some green in there, put some brown, some FDE colors. So I'm gonna go back over it with a little bit of black. We're just gonna dust it. Actually, before we do that, let's just take a peek. just had a little peek, you know, just look. See this little corner right here? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's what we like. Yeah. It's got a little bit of a gloss to it because it hasn't dried yet. But once that dries and kind of flattens out, that'll look great. Another little tip, if you got your rifle out here like this so you can really see what your pattern looks like, and you have some like that spot right there that don't really have a whole lot on it, you can take a smaller piece of your netting that's like flimsy, because once you start getting paint on it, you know, it hardens up and it gets harder to flex. You can take this piece and get it stretched out and kind of tuck it, get it kind of tight, you know, get it about where you want it like that. Take your paint, dust it a little bit with the black. Maybe if you get a little too dark, you're like, ah, I need to lighten that spot up a little bit. Let's just take a look at it real quick. You know, that looks pretty good to me. Pretty good. Okay, we'll just do it. We'll just do it so I can show you guys. Take a little bit of your tan. A little bit of your tan. Spritz it with a little tan. Spritz it with a little black. Pull back. Looks pretty good to me. So probably another question you guys are going to ask. When you're doing one side, it's kind of hard to get completely on the, like, underneath of the rifle. A lot of guys would be like, you know what, when you're holding it, you don't even see that, not a big deal. But like that patch there that doesn't have any, so just kind of drape it over, pack it up under there, push it, get it tight up against there so you can get your pattern. Do a little, just a little dust of black, and then do some tan. Yeah. Come back with the tan. Yeah. Pull back. Bam. Looks pretty good. Looks better than just a big spot of tan. Because what we're really trying to do is just make it a black and tan netting pattern and just kind of ghost it all in together, really. All right, we got the rifle flipped over to the other side. I've actually got it kind of elevated off of the table. The paint's pretty dry to the touch, but if you lay it flat and it'll settle, it'll kind of mess the paint up over there. So I got one of the paint caps over here, and we're just gonna completely restart the process. We've got some like black kind of overspray. So where the overspray is, I guess we'll probably just kind of do the same deal. We're just gonna kind of spritz it on there, no biggie. Dust it on there. Boom, boom, boom. Get that kind of done and you kind of see it for yourself, then that's when you can kind of go back and pick out spots that you want to kind of modify a little bit. And that's whenever you take your smaller piece and stretch it out on there and get it tight. Best part about this stuff, if you mess up, just do it again. Just spray it again. Just try it again. Not make me. That's what I love about spraying. Guys want to spend a bunch of money to go get their stuff Cerakoted. And that's awesome. Cerakote is a lot more durable, but Cerakote's expensive too. Unless you know a guy that knows a guy that knows a guy. This one side looks pretty good. I like it. Let's take a look at the other side. Oh yeah, that looks good. Not too much, not too little.
gonna look good once we get her all thrown together.
All right, paint job number two. Got the Dickinson 12 gauge pump on there. Got her masked up. Not really worried a whole lot with this gun, honestly. I just taped off the front sight post, the tip of the barrel, and the buttstock. Oh, I got the masking tape on the buttstock, but the actual buttstock kind of curves up and curves back out, you know. They had to get fancy for a 10-year-old shotgun, I don't know why. But instead of taking your tape and trying to work it in there and trying to get those curves and stuff, it's hard. So the best thing is, get it on there, take your fingernail, or you know, something with the edge, find that crease. See how I just did that? Then you can take your knife, razor blade, and you can follow that crease. Make sure that's cut all the way through. Boom. Just like that. Like I said, we are not worried about this one. We're just gonna go straight for it and paint it. I'm just gonna pay attention on how much I paint inside here. Obviously, you wanna avoid paint getting heavy down in here, but a little bit of overspray ain't gonna hurt it. Ranger Green Rust-Oleum. That looks like baby shit. But it's alright. Because it will get darkened up with the black that we use. And we're gonna do it just like we did the 6.5. Going a little bit lighter on this base coat. Little bit lighter, because as it darkens, as the base coat dries, you'll see where it's kind of dark from the. Alright, we got a couple good base coats of green on. Let's throw the flat black to her, kind of spot it some, then we'll put the pattern on it. Alright, so we got it striped. I kind of went really, really thin and dusted over it with black because of the green is just too bright. So I darkened it up a little bit. Time to throw the pattern over it. does some more on it. I think I already know what I'm gonna do to this. After I get this done, I think I'm gonna wet sand it a little bit to give it a distorted, battle-worn look, just to break it up even more. Or I'm just gonna go drag it through the rocks or something. We'll see how it goes. See what that looks like. Not bad, not bad. Looks a little bit. Still not 100% satisfied with what I did. Alright, we got her flipped, got the padding on her, repeat the process. Focus on the top here so I don't have a bunch of overspray where I can't shoot angles from the heat. Alright, shotgun don't look too bad now that I've got the pattern on it. Kind of darkened up that green. So we're gonna set this over to the side, let it dry. We're gonna get the 6.5 back over here and start putting it back together. Nice. Yeah, I think it's best if you get both of these. All right, 6.5 Creedmoor done, put back together. It was pretty good and I like it. I kind of think the barrel and stuff's pretty light tan for how dark the stock is, but kind of like the offset color, like that big contrast. I kind of like that, even though I was talking about light dark contrast on the stock, but I think it looks pretty good. Kind of wish I would have took the muzzle brake off and just taped up the threads, because that paint on the inside of that brake, that kind of irritates me. No big deal.